Welcome back to part two.
And we're going to be answering more of your questions that you sent through via Facebook and Twitter.
All right, Andy asks, what's been your favourite storyline this year and what would you like to happen to your characters?
There's been some really good storylines this year. Some of them I haven't been involved in, but that I've actually really enjoyed watching, which I think the Robbo storyline was fantastic. It was really high stakes for everybody. It was a real sense of whodunit. And I love watching my kids do great performances in that, you know, my on-screen children. That was a great thing for me because I was able to sit back and, because I didn't have much to do in the storyline or wasn't integral as, say, some of the other characters, it was just great to be taken on a bit of a wild ride. Mm. So I really enjoyed that Robbo whodunit killed him storyline, and watching what the job Aaron did with that character was just fantastic. For me, I really like the ongoing storyline of the Brad Lauren relationship. I think it's a really great thing to be able to act in those scenes and have a sense of history about things, not knowing exactly where the future's going, because we literally do not know what the writers have in their heads. Edna asks, do you still keep in touch with former castmates like Alan Dale, Jason Donovan and Kylie Minogue?
Well, look, over the years you run into people at events or things, or you work with them again on this show or another show, sure, other projects. So over the years, obviously, I've kept in touch with people. But as time goes on, sometimes you go in different directions or move overseas or interstate. But I try and, keep up with people, but it's a bit hard, you know, when you're busy. And
it's like that with any job in acting, I think. Mm. You know, you spend such intensive times with people and then, you're going over to that job and you're going over to that job and you're still always in, you still think about them, do you know what I mean? Because you spend such quite, you know, intensive times with them.
Yeah.
But, and you know that if you were to see them tomorrow, you'd probably go, hi, how are you? And pick up where you left off, perhaps. But, yeah, it's just the nature of the job.
This is a question from Linda. What happened to Brad and Beth?
Well,
tell.
Brad obviously left Lauren for Beth.
And
not very good at the time, but I've moved on.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So over that. No, I don't, look, I think they got married and they left Ramsey Street long, long time ago. And although they never go into it too much, I just think they got married young.
Mm.
I mean, you probably have to ask them, actually. But, they weren't together for that long. And then he met up with Therese. And, you know, they've got some teenage children now. So that would have been not long after Brad and Beth got together, I would say.
Mm.
So, yeah, I just think, you know, I wanted to do other things. I don't know. Might have to ask Kip. Okay, my turn. Adam asks, what was it like working with a late Neighbours legend, Anne Hattie?
I remember the first day when I came to Neighbours and started playing Lucy Robinson. She just treated me like her granddaughter.
Aww.
She was just gorgeous to work with, and I learnt so much from her. Because she was a fabulous actress, and and when she passed away, it was really sad. Mm. She was really beautiful. She was like my grandmother, really.
Yeah.
Okay. We know the rest of the family skeletons by now. So does Lauren have any in her closet that we're not aware of?
Ooh,
anything?
Well, yes, the family does have a lot of skeletons.
Really?
Oh, our family's always getting into trouble with things that have happened in their lives or keeping secrets from each other, things like that, which seems to happen a lot.
Mm.
But I'm tipping Lauren's going to have a couple of her own. I don't think...
Really?
Yeah, I think she's such a good person, Lauren, and it would just be... Would it just be too unneighbours-y to be just purely too good?
Yeah, it's just too
so she's
got to
have a few skeletons, some of which I'm aware of, which I probably shouldn't talk about, and others which I'm sure that they'll happen over the years. So Gillian asks, will we see more scenes between Lucy and her niece Kate?
Maybe. I'm not too sure, like, what the writers have got planned, but because we've only got Paul Robinson, my brother, and then Kate, my niece, and then myself, Lucy. So, this time round, Kate, a lot of my scenes are with you.
Yes, they are, aren't they? We've had a lot of scenes. We've had a couple of scenes out by the lake.
Yes.
We've been doing a bit of remembering and going back through some...
bit of going back through time.
Back through time. Bit of history. And we've had some pretty in-depth conversations, quite emotional ones at times, about...
It's been really interesting.
Yeah, about where my character's at. And because we've got this rapport... and because our characters knew each other, I open up to you about a few things that are going on.
We've remained sort of friends, and then I sort of come back, and then you sort of feel maybe you could.
I can trust you, you also know, the people involved. So I feel like we can. We share common ground, and you're the one person in my life at the minute that I'm able to talk to and trust implicitly. So, yeah, there's some juicy stuff coming up.
I could be the keeper of a really good secret.